Welcome to another episode of Gas Diesel Garage, everyone. In today's episode, we got one of my favorites, a Honda. Honda Accord, that is. And this thing is throwing a P420 code. And usually, that calls for a bad catalytic converter. But we're going to diagnose it today, so stay tuned. Now, being that we're working on a Honda, I think it's only necessary that we get in uniform. Not this uniform, even though that's the merch right there, Gas Diesel Garage. But, yes, I think we should get in the uniform. All right, that's better. Get me back to my Honda roots. Time to get to work. Now, we're going to diagnose this two different ways. Well, the first off is we're gonna check it with the computer, check the check engine light, check the graph, check the O2 sensors, see if they're working properly, and see if we got a clog. But usually, P0420 is consistent with a clogged catalytic converter, which you'll see your O2 sensors fall off. And the next thing, we're gonna check it the temperature manually. We're gonna check it before and after the cat. And if you got two different readings for temperatures from the front and the back, yeah, you got a clogged catalytic converter, because if this was the front side, it'd be really, really, really hot. And on the back side, it'll be really, really low. And that's how you know you got a clogged catalytic converter. As you can see, we have three DTCs in this ECU, so we have three check engine lights on, or codes rather. So let's go ahead and check that out. Okay, let's read the fault codes. Ah, there you go. First one popped up was the catalytic system efficiency below threshold bank one, and then the throttle positioning sensor. Yeah, I don't think that really has anything to do with our problem here, but that O2 sensor does, because remember I was telling you, if you got a clogged catalytic converter, yes, this bank two sensor that's after the cat, that's gonna read completely bonkers haywire. So looks like we have a problem with the catalytic converter, but let's go check the live data. Well, unfortunately, my nice scan tool decided to take a crap on me, so we had to go old school and get the Solus out, but we can still read the live data right here. The first thing I want to pull your attention to is this one right here, the cat monitor temp bank 2 NG. Pretty much that means no go, meaning that thing ain't reading a darn thing. So let's go back over here. Let's go up a little more. Go down to the oxygen sensors. Okay, right there. That voltage should be changing rapidly, more than that 0.68 and 0.7. Let's see if we rev it up. Let's see if it'll change. As you can see, revving it, it's not changing much, which that's one electronic controlled signs of you got a bad cat. So let's see. Now that we checked the ECU with the scan tool, and that's pointing to a bad cat, because it's not giving us any kind of readings or bad readings per se. So the next thing we need to do is we need to take a manual temperature reading, and that is with the infrared temp gun. I think that's how you say it. Now that you got the vehicle up to temperature and running when you take this temperature reading, check it before the cat, right there. The 326, right around there. Now you want to do it after the cat. Should be right here. See what that reads. .206, .230, that's not good. It should be about the same. So, looks like we're replacing the catalytic converter. And here's a tip. Get yourself some PB Blaster. That's some good stuff there. And spray all those bolts down, because they will break on you. So let's try to loosen that stuff up. Well, unfortunately, over the years, Honda is famous for this. See how bad that heated up? Well, those nuts are pretty much done. They're 12 millimeter bolts that you need to take out, 1, 2, and 3. And I can't really get those out, so what we're gonna do is we're gonna get it out with a fire wrench, my favorite. And when you start doing stuff with the torch, make sure you take your O2 sensor out first. And word of the wise, make sure you let the car cool down before you start touching it, because you'll get severely burned. I know from experience. Alright, 102 sensor out. The catalytic converter, make sure you put your gaskets in the right place. This one right here goes right there on that circle. Make sure that stays in there. Oop, right there, like that. And then that one, self-explanatory, goes in like that. And make sure you have to replace the bolts also. The reason I put a pair of vice grips to hold the flanges together is because that little circle gasket ring, that thing is a pain in the butt to hold in there. So just put that in there, clamp it down, and just hit them bolts. Put your O2 sensor back in. Now that we got the catalytic converter installed, it's time to change back into the channel's uniform. That's much better. All right, now what we need to do is we need to start that vehicle up and make sure that check engine light doesn't come back on. Sounds a lot better also. And there's something I didn't mention also. When you know that you got a bad catalytic converter, your exhaust will smell really, really bad. I'm talking about bad and make your eyes burn. So that's another step that you can take to diagnose a catalytic converter. You know, not the professional diagnosis, but it's something that you can smell. Well, good news is no more check engine light. Well, that's going to be a wrap for this episode of Gas Diesel Garage. Make sure you like and subscribe and hit that bell for the post notifications so you don't miss a thing. See you next time. Peace.